Greetings once again, Jujutsu Sorcerers, Duuz-Diz-Din, back again with Jujutsu Kaisen. Previously, Gojo and Geto have been tasked with protecting Reiko Amai, the Star Plasma Vessel. Essentially, she will be possessed by, I believe, the leader of the Jujutsu schools, who also has the ability to mass this various schools with his energy from their enemy. While I was initially a bit skeptical about the nature of this, Reiko seems to believe that it is more of a merging of two peoples living in harmony, rather than a possession. However, she's still determined to go to school and live her last day of schooling as normally as possible, understandably, since her life is about to change. However, Toji Fushiguro, much like others before him, have been tasked with assassinating Reiko. But Toji is no fool. He knows that Gojo has a lot of power behind him, and so he has put a bounty out on Reiko's head, bringing in smaller time Jujutsu sorcerers, who will not be able to take down and actually kill Reiko, but will at the very least distract and wear down our hero. And during the commotion and scuffle, Reiko's maid, Kuroi, is kidnapped. The question now is, will Gojo and Geto actually bother to try to save her, as she is not their main objective? Or will they do just that, and put Reiko in harm's way? Join me as I find out, won't you?
The underwater? The heck is going on? Oh, phone call. She asleep? Wake up!
From Kuroi. What do we do? Kuroi has been. There's always a chance the worst could happen. You're much faster than me. So go ahead and hurry to Reiko's side.
I'm sorry. This was my mistake.
Really? I don't think this even counts as a mistake. I underestimated how much our enemies would value Kuroi. Their next moves would probably offering arrange an exchange for her. Something like trading Amai for Kuroi. Or saying they'll kill Kuroi if we don't kill Amanai.
But we have the leverage in any negotiations since we have Amanai. As long as they set up a location for a deal, we can make it work out. I'm taking Amai back to Jujutsu High now. We can have Shoko or someone stand in as her body double. Hold on, I'm going to the CL2. I still can't trust you two yet, huh?
You're still saying that after all this, even if you do manage to save her.
What if Kuroi isn't back before I assimilate with Tengen? I haven't even said goodbye to her.
Okay, see, that's what I'm saying. It's like, something about this murder situation doesn't, like, regardless, it's like, everything you knew previously disappears.
The kidnappers will reach out to us eventually. If they seem like they're smarter than we expect, and bringing you with us is likely to hurt Kuroi's chance of survival, then we will leave you behind.
Alright, that works.
Ooh, love those eyes. In exchange, if you get scared partway through and you want to go home, we'll just ignore you.
Bear that in mind.
Huh? What? What?
Mensore?
What? 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 Wait! Protective mission day 2. Wait, what? Did we just skip over Okinawa?
What? Wait, what? What the hell did I miss?
Episode 27 in Hidden Inventory 3.
What? We're not just gonna skip over them rescuing Kuroi, are we?
I still can't believe I got captured by the Star Religious Group and by a non-sorcerer as that.
Kuroi, come on. I should've trained more.
I'm ashamed of myself. You couldn't help it if they caught you off guard. Part of the blame lies with me too.
Was I really caught off guard?
Huh. I thought I was on high alert after the incident with Q.
Oh, there it is. Nice. It's that simple, huh?
I still don't have much recollection of being attacked. You all came here by plane? Are you okay?
Something about that feels honest. She doesn't remember being attacked? This feels like a setup.
You weren't attacked? Satoru has good eyes. Where we took off, he checked over all the passengers and staff.
And we all were inside the plane.
As well as the inside and outside of the plane.
Jeez.
And while we were in the air, I had my cursed spirits keep watch outside.
Oh, jeez.
It was safer than using a land route. I'm mere curious as to why they designated Okinawa for the exchange. Probably to buy time, right? Even if they failed to save Reiko.
Travel schedule, day 1. 1330, Kuroi kidnapped, 2100 hours. Kidnappers designate Okinawa as the exchange. Day 2, 9 o'clock, Gojo, Geto, and Amai arrive in Okinawa. 11 o'clock, rescue Kuroi, capture kidnappers. 12, finish interrogation. 13, swing at the beach, that's now. 1500 hours, whatever. Day 3, 11, Amai's bounty takedown. Assimilate with Tengen after sunset.
Oh, even if they fail to kill Reiko-sama, they could keep her from making tomorrow's full moon deadline, if that were the goal.
I love the little character, V!
if that were the goal. You would have chose a rural area with poor transit infrastructure.
Right.
You don't think they're planning to take over the airport, do you? Maybe so, but we'll be fine. We're not the only ones who came here. Ah, some backup. Clearly this isn't a mission fit for a first year.
Whoa, that's Nanami? What? I keep seeing this character in the opening and I'm like, who the hell is that? What?
Oh my, okay, that was not what I was expecting.
Huh.
Wow, young Nanami is a lot different than what I expected. Then again, older businessman versus young, almost looks like a punk.
Oh my god, though. And he was a first year, too.
I'm psyched, though. Hibari Yu.
Yeah, no, Hibara.
I don't recognize this character, but
either they're dead or they show up later on in the series.
Or I don't recognize. No, no.
Don't remember the name.
He has a lot of Yuji energy, though. I'm psyched, though. I want to show off in front of Geto, too.
Aw.
Besides, I hear our upper classes are wearing themselves to the bone to protect an innocent young girl, so we have to give it our all, too.
Aw, man. Is this why Nanami is actually kind of sweet on Yuji?
If a typhoon rolls in and shuts down the airport, our efforts will be for naught.
Like, that's gonna happen.
Oh, ew. Upper class is wearing themselves to the bone. Ew, what is that?
Sea cucumber.
Oh, it's ew, ew.
Gross, that's so gross. Ew.
Should we really be sightseeing like this?
Toto's the one who suggested it.
He's probably showing consideration for Rico in his own way.
Aw.
Well, it's getting close. Toto's time.
Sorry, that time.
Aw.
He's actually getting sweet on her.
So, Gary, let's head back tomorrow morning instead.
Nope.
But the weather's holding steady, right? Besides, there are fewer curse users in Okinawa than there are in Tokyo. Keep it a little more serious, Toto.
I mean, I don't actually understand that.
It's better if the time limit on the bounty runs out while we're in mid-flight, right?
That's actually a good point.
Satoru, you haven't released your technique since yesterday, have you?
Oh, is that where we're seeing his eyes so much?
You haven't slept either, and you don't plan to sleep tonight, do you? Are you sure you don't need to head back to Jujutsu High?
It's not a problem.
Playing through 99 years of Motetsu was far more training.
What the hell?
Besides, you're here too.
Aww.
Nanami, they said they're extending to stay another day. You think something happened?
Yep, that's Nanami.
Oh, man.
Aww.
Oh, really?
Aww.
Yeah, he really did get sweet on her.
Oh, man.
These shots are beautiful.
Aww.
Oh, wow. And they really are giving her what feels like one last good real day.
Oh. Really?
Jeez, this is freaking beautiful.
Huh.
Oh. Gee.
Goddamn.
Y'all are doing the most. But it also really has a sense of finality, too. Jujutsu High Foothills, Mount Mushira. Protection mission day 3. 1500 hours.
Yeah, this should be by the limit.
Yeah, because it was at 11 that the bounties were leave. But wasn't this part of Choji's plan, though? Because while the bounty he put out was released, is he gonna strike now? But they're already at Jujutsu High, or at least just outside of it. So he's not really gonna attack right in Jujutsu High, right?
Good work, everyone. We're inside Jujutsu High's barrier now.
Okay, they're inside the barrier. Oh, is there some trap?
What a relief.
Yes.
Huh.
Satoru,
you really worked hard this time.
I never want to get stuck babysitting a brat again.
What the hell?
Oh, what the fuck? What the fuck? So it was a trap. Impossible. We're inside Jujutsu High's barrier. Or because Tengen is at his weakest now?
That could only be it.
The fuck?
Okay, I know Gojo doesn't die from this, but Jesus.
Have we met before?
Don't worry about it.
I'm terrible at remembering guys' names too.
Jesus.
Hey.
Huh. What?
I once went to see the brat born into the Gojo clan with the six eyes on a lark.
Oh.
Ooh. That's Gojo.
With his mom?
Hmm. Ah. Oh, surreal. Never before or after that. Had anyone noticed me standing behind them?
Oh,
so you have a special ability?
That's why I wore him down.
Genius.
Yeah.
Awake the entire time until his senses dulled.
Oh, nice.
Oh, couldn't be that simple though.
Satoru.
Oh, I'm fine. Said the guy who was stabbed through the chest. I didn't make it in time with my technique, but it missed my vitals.
Oh, okay.
I then strengthened myself with curse energy, so the blade couldn't be drawn out at all. It was like fate. Passing a safety pin through a knit sweater.
Oh,
I mean, that went through both your vertebrae and your sternum.
I
don't completely understand how that works, but anime logic. Take your word for it. Seriously, I'm fine. Prioritize on Manai first. I'll deal with this guy. So here, you two get there to Tengen. Oh no. Satoru. I kind of feel like Geto should be the one to face off with this guy. He's a little bit more rested. I mean, all things considered, it makes more sense that Gojo stayed awake and kept her protected that entire time. That way, you know, Geto stays rested and is at his fullest. Or is Toji too much for Geto? Be careful. Let's go. Oh, who do you think you're talking to? It might be too much for Geto. Ugh, that's different from the blade he stabbed me with. And where did that cursed spirit come from? Oh, too many unknowns, damn it. Yeah, it's weird to see Gojo not knowing what's up. The star plasma vessel is gone. I had hoped to take you down with that earlier attack. I guess I've gotten rusty. The bounty on Amanai has already been taken down, you idiot. Yeah, he thinks he's one of the bounty hunters. Because I took it down, prideful bastard. We're facing people without openings like you. You have to first create ups and downs leading to several false goals. I laughed when those star religious group men went to Okinawa. It sucked that none of the sorcerers around her died. But if I hadn't set that time limit on the bounty, you wouldn't have released your technique until the very end. Yeah, that's so. Oh, he's fast. And not just that. I knew there was something off about him. He has zero cursed energy. Wait, what? He has a heavenly pack gifting him physical prowess. So kind of like with Maki? But he's not wearing glasses, so... All the benefits of Maki with none of the downsides of not being able to see and use cursed technique? Or can he not use cursed technique? Is that why he has that creature? Kind of like how our Fushiguro's able to pull weaponry out of his Shinigami. Is that a Shinigami? Huh. Oh, Jesus. Oh, whoa, whoa. What the hell? Oh. And this is Gojo worn down. Jeez. Can't imagine anyone who knows my technique coming without a plan. The cursed tool refresh a trump card. Sorry, but I won't let it get close. It's still so weird to see Gojo taken off guard. Did he disappear? Oh, what the hell? What? Is he just that fast? Jesus. This guy kind of feels more like Todo than Megumi. Since he has no cursed energy, I can't read its presence. I can't just rely on instinct. There's that cursed spirit wrapped around him. I just need to follow its presence. Even so, how's he? He's too damn fast. Oh, cursed technique amplification. Maximum output. Is it actually gonna work? Jeez, blue. Oh. Jeez. Just create a wave of destruction. There's no cover. He can't launch surprise attacks. Oh, he was just clearing away any place he could hide behind. Jesus. Wouldn't that have worn him out too? Oh, did he hide in the woods? What the hell is that? Are those head flies? Yeah, we've seen those before, right? Just not in such numbers. Was he keeping them inside that cursed spirit? So you're using fly heads like chaff? Yeah, with such a legion of these things. Actually gives him a place to hide behind. Nah, I can't tell where he is. You created a blind spot. I should use blue again. No, wait. He's after. His intuition is keen enough to sense me empty-handed. There's no way your six eyes would overlook an unusual cursed energy oozing from this cursed tool. Finality. Got you to focus on defense with your technique. How though? If it's infinity, should have stopped it. What is that blade? Oh, Jesus. Oh, man. Oh, jeez. It did his leg for good measure? Oh, he could still attack. Oh, dude. Oh, what? And use just another knife for the head? How did Gojo survive this? This is a great cursed tool, inverted spear of heaven. Its effect is the forced release of any active technique. Oh, jeez. I think. You think? I'm getting my edge back now. Jesus. No wonder Gojo has a special interest in Megumi. But why is there nobody else around? What was there nobody else to receive Gojo and Geto? I mean, the moment they got back to Jujutsu High, you think they would have been met by others? Or are they that understaffed? I mean, for such an important ceremony. Or were they that confident nothing would happen? Jesus. Oh, how did we survive this? It should have been too late. He has to be too late. And this deep down. Rika, this is as far as I go. Rika, please, please. Aw, okay. I love you. Aw, I always have and I always will. Me too. She just really feels like she's gonna die. Aw, and they're walking pretty casually. Unless they somehow have a trap this far down. So this is, yeah, we're in Tengen's territory now. Whoa, this is the foundation of the national key barriers. Yeah, just key barriers, huh? The main hall of the Tomb of the Stars. Once you descend the stairs, pass through the gate and continue to the base of the big tree, then you'll be inside the special barrier that separates from the barrier surrounding Jujutsu High. Only those invited are able to enter. I think it will protect you until the assimilation. That, or you can turn back around and go home with Kuroi. Really? Huh. When our teacher told us about this mission, he called the assimilation erasing. Right. He was trying to tell us to be aware of how heavy the sin that was. Our teacher may be a muscle brain, but he often does roundabout things. Satoru and I already talked it over before we met you. Is that even allowed? What if the star plasma vessel brat refuses to assimilate? Then the assimilation's off. Really? Are you sure about that? Huh? It might mean fighting Tengen, you know. Really? You scared? Huh. It's fine. It'll all work out somehow. Huh. We are the strongest. No matter what decision you make, we will guarantee your future. Huh. I have always been special since the day I was born. Everyone kept telling me that I was different. Oh, being special was normal to me. And I've lived my life trying to avoid danger as much as possible for the sake of this day. I don't really remember the day my mother and father died. Huh. I no longer feel sad or lonely about that. I figured everything would be fine, even if it was taken away before everyone had assimilated. That no matter how hard it was, it would stop feeling sad and lonely one day. Huh. But, honestly, I want to be with everyone longer. I wanted to go to all kinds of places with everyone. I want to see all kinds of things and do more. Let's go home, Rika. Yeah. What? No! What? What? No! What? No! But she didn't want to go through with it. Oh my god. Oh my god. No. That's... Oh my god. No. That's just too cruel. Oh, no. No. I don't understand. You're kidding me. I knew something had to happen. I was hoping it was going to be like a situation with Yuta where we were going to pick up and present and see that she was okay. Or maybe she was forced to assimilate and that's why Geto broke away from things and Gojo just went with it and that's why they're on the outs or something, but dude. Motherfucker. Give me your dad is a fucking bastard. And I hope he dies. I really do. Okay, job's done. You're free to go now. Why are you here? That's what you mean. Because I killed Gojo Satoru. What the hell is that? Is that so? Die. Don't show me this. I can't even begin to tell you how upset I am right now. That is so cruel. I should have known because this is a flashback. The worst kinds of things happen in flashbacks and things were going so well, but I figured maybe the problem was that they accomplished their mission or something. I feel so bad for Reiko. I feel bad for Kuroi. So good to know that stopped recording halfway through. Fan-friggin-tastic. Can't really do much about that, but at least the audio was still going. I kept looking to make sure my stuff was recording, and it says it was, but it was only getting my audio. Thanks a lot. Well, you kind of missed out on a lot of me crying, essentially. Man. Should've known. I had a bad feeling about, like, something told me something bad was gonna happen, and it... In both the episode and in my recording, nothing but tragedy all around. But yeah, I'm still not happy what happened to Reika. Megumi made it sound like his dad is still around, which, goddamn, fuck that guy, honestly. What a bummer. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Like, I'm so depressed. Between the recording and this, like, I'm really bummed out right now.
So let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And until next time, I've been Duuz-Diz-Din. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next. Take care. Bye-bye.